burning down the job centre tomorrow. I'm going to sort a proper job, and that's definite.
You've caught us marginally on the hop, coming back rather earlier than envisaged.
And marvellous to have you back, Debbie.
I'm looking for a cook.
Sorry, Dad, can I introduce you? This is Petula. She's our new cook.
Salfordians. They're lit.
Lit?
That could be them now.
Stop here. I'm allergic to sheep.
What's the card say? Marry in haste, repent at leisure. And what's more, you better make the most of this. I'll be wanting this place to myself again. Once you've all settled in across there.
If it's depressing, I don't want it.
What's the question?
I want to know when Vincent's going to phone and how long we have to put up with this purgatory. I'm not having that for the kickoff. Oh, oh, oh. I don't believe in it anyway.
Little more care required, Oliver. Ah, Morty.
Yes?
Joanna.
Yes?
Do this sort of thing as a rule. A spur of the moment behaviour. This tenancy business. Well, except she thought it was the best, trying to help us out, etc. Nevertheless, manner of her taking the reins, dangerously close to impulsive. Something to be nipped in the bud, I'd have thought. Ooh. Central heating doesn't sound too clever. Phoenix, ring upstairs. Ask someone to look into it.
Drive down here in his brand new Mercedes and take us off to live in Marbella. And I'm going to lie in the sun and get brown and wear gold bracelets and drink martinis.
Don't hold your breath. You could be sat waiting for another 8 years.
Just zip it, Deck.
Hmm.
They're looking for a new music master at school. Did I tell you?
Well, I don't want to teach.
Well, I must say, I've always found it the most rewarding, the most fulfilling, the most...
I don't want to teach. And if I did, it wouldn't be there.
I'd like to point out that Daddy spent a great deal of money sending us there to be taught a few basic lifelong principles.
Bigotry, dogmatism, intolerance.
And I, for one, would like to register a personal vote of thanks for all his generosity in that direction.
Daddy!
Morty? Pressing need to establish some boundaries.
Sorry, pal.
Where these people may or may not trespass, for example. My experience, these types always fare better if one lays down a few simple rules at the outset. All due respect to Pamela, of course.
Can I take these, Phoenix?
8:47 and 19 seconds, Your Excellency.
Why is he still called Excellency when he's off duty?
He's probably forgotten to give the badge back, Di.
Don't strain yourself.
I don't know why you bother. It's only somewhere to crash. Once the heat's gone off, we can shift back again.
To what? The bailiffs? The bizzies? Jed trying to nail me head to the sideboard.
I can't keep in that room. Keep looking over my shoulder for Dracula.
Oh, Vincent's going to have to pull his finger out. This is not my idea of a good time.
My dad's doing a jig round the spud patch. I told you it'd be right up his street.
Gran's mustard, though, ain't she? Getting him to crack open his wallet.
You ever known her to say jump and him not vault the pole?
What's this?
Leftovers.
Kippers? For breakfast? Weird.
They are weird. Off their heads and up their arse. Except Joanna. And Alistair's all right. I mean, he doesn't twitch or wear mascara.
She fancies him.
I do not.
Look at her. She's gone bloodshot.
Get stuffed.
Tell him you wear a paper bag and keep the lights off.
Hello. Just wondered how you're all settling in. A cup of sugar. Is that the custom?
My dad prefers condensed milk. Bardex, he'll have it on his butties. Go in, they've got a brew on.
Well, if it's no trouble. I'm afraid my father still imagines he's living with a staff of 20.
We've got guests.
Hello. Alistair, how do you do?
Carmen.
Excuse me. You won't be offended if I throttle him.
Oh, is this yours? Do you mind if I,
You play a bit, then.
It's been known.
So, what did you get up to round here?
You mean nightlife?
Any life.
She means what's the scene, where's the clubs?
Ah, well, clubs, little thin on the ground. In terms of the scene, I don't know if it qualifies, but there's really only the Elbow.
The what?
It's the local pub, you know. Of course, it's not everyone's idea of a night spot, but it does stock some interesting beers.
Well, now we're talking. Who fancies a bevy?
Oh, when I say local, it's actually about 3 miles away.
And what's the nearest bus stop?
About 5 miles away.
How long are you meant to get anywhere, then? Hijack a pig van?
Well, one's minus a car, one generally walks.
Walk? You won't get her walking. She'll be stuck here for life.
Oh, will I?
Something in particular?
You, Mort. Your attention. Some spark of interest, perhaps? How long's he staying, your father?
Who knows? Awaiting new posting seems to be the official line.
Well, that's wishful thinking. Any chance of her being posted to the Foreign Legion?
Phoenix? Ah, but would Parr construe that as a particularly useful move? Seems hardly able to function without her.
I'd rather think that's her intention. I suppose there's not the faintest chance of you joining me for lunch.
Isn't there? Unlikely, I'd have thought. Verdi Requiem looming. It's a question of priorities.
I'm wondering, Mort, what does one do to qualify as a priority? Perhaps I should just cultivate a halo.
I'm sorry? Oh, I see, it's a joke. Was it? Yes. Oh, very good.
12:30, Gorse office.
What is?
Meeting. Accounts, next year's budget projections.
12:30 is not good. I have a session with Signor Spotti.
Who?
My singing teacher.
Morty. This is getting out of hand. It's fine as a hobby, but it starts to impinge upon the real world.
There again, the real world can accommodate musicians, Pa. Alistair, for instance?
Alistair?
There's the excuse of being relatively immature. Your age has hopes that common sense might prevail. It's not as if, God forbid, you've any plans to make a career out of it.
Not convinced I feel ready to commit myself to that step, huh?
Well, you think you might commit yourself to the question of the grazing lands? Last quarter's income figure's quite abysmal. That's a thank for this tenancy fiasco.
Eureka! Oh, Bamba Mackety's come to mama.
Bamba Mackety's is my laptop. This guy has one hell of a mind. Now we are going places.
Have you got a minute?
Pardon?
It's him, his lordship. He's a bit handy with his jingle bells.
His what?
He's at it every other minute. It's like bloody Notre Dame up there.
Oh, I see.
Yes, I'm afraid he does tend to think the world's at his beck and call. Well, there's a very simple solution.
You hella bore and I just looking at my chot ass.
What? Oh, the Christmas roses. Yes, I'm afraid there's no one to really look after them.
Do you know the fetidus variety? Huh? Stinking helly bore of the clever Betty's Scarlet. I think I might have a wee cutting bursting into bloom somewhere. Come up.
Up? Up where? What?
Was it two sugars or three?
Oh, I'm not really allowed sugar. Or biscuits in between meals.
Well, I'll not tell if you don't. Stuffed.
I'm sorry?
An old flame of mine was into this caper. You had to watch you didn't sit still for too long when he was about. Now then, do you know the one about the Pope and the Knickerbocker glory?
I don't think so.
Oh,
just off out, Dad. Mm. What are you doing?
What's her name? Pamela. The devil disappeared.
Petula. And it's her night off.
Well, one of the others, then.
Dad, we're not paying them. They're paying us.
What is that?
Why don't I go and investigate? Was that your own composition?
I'm working on it. To do a bit.
I tried to, yes.
Why are we killing? Killing, killing, killing.
Well, Andrew Lloyd Webber's banging his nails.
You know it, Carmen.
Ah, those shoes. I'm not sure they're really ideal for the terrain. I think we've got some galoshes somewhere.
You what? Wellies?
Well, it's just this time of year. It's the mud. I'm not sure how you'll get across.
Don't worry. We'll find us someone to step on.
Oh, God, how disgusting.
It's like something out of The Omen.
Country law. Scares off other predators. Better get used to it, I'm afraid.
No, Tad, I'd sooner see the video.
Could devise a more convivial way of passing the evening. Nobody watching that, were they?
They were, actually.
Can we form two teams?
Pints, brandy and baby sham, and a Malibu and Guinness.
Come without me wallet.
But all the use it'd be.
Do we get introduced, or does it keep your paws off?
Oh, she's not. I mean, we're not. Actually, they're tenants. I mean, my father's tenants.
What happened to the blonde one?
Francesca. Mm-hmm. Bit of a sore point, actually. Sorry, let me introduce you. This is Nelson, the landlord. Petula, Declan and Carmen.
How do? Oh, eh. Competition for you, Wes.
Where's your Prince Charming then, love?
What do you mean?
Well, you must have somebody keeping your slippers warm.
I do. He's away.
Oh, it's like that, is it?
Like what?
Well, oh, a bit dodgy.
I'm very particular what I drape round my shoulders. Thank you.
So, you're not coursing then?
No. Not exactly.
Did you give her the elbow?
Yes. Yes, I suppose that's what it amounts to.
Was it the socks or the toothpaste?
No, actually, she gave me an ultimatum. Get a finer fax or I'm leaving you.
Do you what?
Yeah, it seemed fine when we were students together, but since she joined the real world, my lack of organisation seems to offend her. What about you? Courting.
Ha!
Sorry?
People don't court this. They wave garlic at it.
Well, you seem to like it.
I'm used to it.
It certainly makes a statement. Anyway, cheers.
I'll try and shut the racket off.
All right.
Good night. You can take my place, Ali. It's neck and neck.
Question was, who commanded the British forces at the Battle of Balaclava, October the 25th, 1854?
Lord Raglan? No.
Someone perked up. She's all right now she's found an audience.
You never know. I might dig up a rich farmer to keep me going till Vincent gets his act together.
She'll have no trouble finding any takers. She was tripping over tongues on the way out.
What's your gob took a knock for? If you've got it, why not flash it?
Yeah, great, but if you're giving out green, don't be surprised if some bugger doesn't jump the red light.
Meaning what?
If you're playing the Vestal Virgin, hadn't you better start dressing for it?
I dress for myself.
Not from where them lads are stood. All they see is offers time at Tesco's.
Give over, will you? The only one getting his hands on this is Vincent.
Carmen! I wish I could say it was worth it.
Shan't be a tick. Just nipping up to check on Ryan.
Excuse me. Have we met?
Boyd Tundish. How do you do?
Did you want something?
Not at the moment, thanks.
Hey, do you mind? This is our maiden's room.
Yes, but you see, it's my only access to the telescope. None of the other staff would mind it.
Yeah, but we don't happen to be staff. We're paying through the nose for this place, and that includes some privacy.
I don't know whether any of you saw this morning's Guardian. A UFO sighting over the massive Centrale in France. Great news for Chewy!
Who the frig's Chewy?
Chewy Chewson, co-founder of the Clitheroe Unidentified Flying Object Society. A great man. And, in his way, a prophet. Now missing for 3 months.
What has he done to Dusty?
Dusty?
Has he legged it?
Oh, no. No, not in my book. No, to my mind, and I must say, I'm not alone in the belief, Chewy Chewson is up there somewhere.
What, you mean he's dead?
No, when I say up there, I mean quite literally. Up there. You see, we may not know a lot about astral migration at this stage, but that doesn't mean we can afford to be sceptical about it. There are more things in heaven and earth than are dreamt of in our philosophy.
Hamlet.
I'm sorry?
Act 1, scene 5. Actually, it's your philosophy.
What is?
More things in heaven and earth. See, we're not all as daft as we look. That's Orion. Why is it so clear? Must be the dark.
What dark?
The stars look dead bright. You never see it like that at home.
Where's that? Here we go. Ketchup and mustard and sugar. Now we're up and running. Bloody heating's gone again. This is the only place guaranteed not to give you frostbite.
There we are, Daddy. You'll be fine in here. Can I fix the boiler? Let me clear some space for you. Here we are.
I have to say, not wildly enthusiastic about you tinkering with the fuses, boy.
Daddy, I know exactly what the problem is. Ignition switch isn't firing.
Phoenix?
At school, it happens all the time. Father Casper's only too happy to let me disappear for hours on end to get it going again.
Letter for posting, second class, marked urgent. Ah, Mortimer. 3 extra seats for tonight.
Let me guess. Musical chairs?
Guests for supper. Father Casper, Major and Mrs. Booty. Permission to push the boat out on this occasion, Pamela? New Year's. Something of a major festivity in my book. Chance to take stock, redefine objectives, start as we mean to go on, etc.
Excuse me. You'll have to shift unless you want the arse burnt off the pudding.
Fuse box. This way. Boyd Tundish, how do you do? Well, that won't go down very well with Daddy. He takes a dim view of blasphemy.
All right.
Good for you. Hello. Fuse box.
Dad was wondering where the tea's got to. The bell seems to be on the blink.
Does it?
Well, why don't I fix it? You've obviously got your hands full.
When are you going back to London?
It's when I can face the prospect of looking for a flat. Or freezing my arse off giving mandolin recitals outside Leicester Square tube station.
You ask him for a thick ear?
Sorry?
Use a teacup, he'll have a fit if you give him a mug.
I know. But it won't kill him to join the real world once in a while.
You call this place the real world?
Well, I suppose I could always get a job as a waiter.
I wouldn't bet on it.
He's trying to take to water like a duck too.
I hate New Year. You always feel like you're meant to have something to look forward to.
Rich puts the pigeon on a deck chair to dry out.
Who's the specky one?
Boyd. Why?
He's not a full deck.
You'd see why if you met his dad.
I'll give that a miss.
what's happened?
And I don't for a moment think it would have happened if the whole circuit hadn't been very ropey indeed. In fact, I was very lucky not to do serious damage to my eardrum. So actually, Daddy, I think I deserve to be congratulated rather than given a reprimand.
Very unimpressive performance, boy. And granted, they're only tenants, but they're entitled to some illumination.
I can't get anyone to come out at this short notice.
Hmm?
What with it being New Year's Eve?
Astonishing.
I suppose we should be grateful you haven't blown the fuses in both wings.
Bit rough on the tenants, though. No lights, no cooking facilities.
It's all right, Mort. I've come up with the ideal solution. On the side, spoons.
I don't think it's a good idea.
You don't?
There's no need for it.
It's just a goodwill gesture.
Ah, may I? It's your bathroom. How's the singing going then? You're still having lessons?
Oh, on and off, yes. Only a hobby, of course.
Is it? You don't fancy taking it any further?
As in?
I don't know. Part-time classes? Maybe the odd audition?
Oh, well, it's a big step. I'm not convinced there'll be overwhelming support for it in some quarters.
You mean Dad?
Yeah. Knowing his view on music as a career.
Tell me about it.
Do you have anything on the horizon?
Yeah, masses. Just nothing at the moment. So Dad, of course, feels completely justified in writing me off.
Yeah, well, he's certainly adept at that.
Well, then, there's no point in hanging around waiting for his approval. If you want to do something, you get out there and do it.
Oh.
What?
I wanted that bath.
Well, I was here first.
Yes, but I happen to be older than you. And more to the point, I actually live here.
So do I.
Not officially. Technically, you're a guest. I've never really left home, so I think that puts me higher up in the pecking order.
Is it fancy dress tonight?
You mean, is it formal? Apparently so. Best bib and all that.
I haven't got a best bib.
Oh, what a surprise.
I just don't happen to think you need to be starched up to the eyeballs just to enjoy a meal.
Well, actually, Ali, since this is the first time you've been together en famille for absolutely yonks, I think you could make the effort. No, but presumably you think it's clever to lower the tone of the festivities.
Who mentioned lowering the tone?
Ah, drawing room, 7:30, sharp. Mort, can I have a word? Just caught some rather alarming news.
This side. No show without punch.
No.
He's not stopping. He just nipped in to catch a quick nightcap.
Sorry to hear your brother's not feeling well. Aren't we waiting for someone else?
You wouldn't happen to have Nellie Dean at your fingertips?
I'm sorry?
There's an old mill by the stream. Nellie Dean.
I'm afraid I don't know that one.
Roger, can I make some formal introductions? Mr. Belcher, Aki. Carmen, Nathan, my father-in-law, Roger. Phoenix, Boyd, Oliver, and Mrs. Grogan.
You're looking a bit peaky, old son. Could it be your bowels by any chance?
Major and Mrs. Booty. Old friends of the family. Can I introduce some newer friends? Major Booty suffers from high blood pressure.
Has he tried the water of life? Oh, 'tis a powerful cure. At home, we drink it by the glassful.
Friends, not precisely the term I'd have chosen. Good to see you, Jazz. Elspeth.
The first slash of the day. You can't beat it. Cheers.
Cheers. Night, Dad.
I believe I'm expected. Father Caspar. Good evening, my child. The year fast fadeth. Any sins you have on your conscience, feel free to bare your breast in my direction.
Thank you, Father. I'll see what I can dredge up for you.
Urgent need of a cloth. The old lady spilt something unpleasant all over the ottoman.
His nibs fell upon lean times, then. If he's that desperate, he should flog the family silver.
What's he got on him?
Too true. Covered to this stuff.
Our Esme used to do a bit of cleaning for him. She accidentally left the premises with a pocket full of teaspoons.
Have you seen the ghost? Place is haunted, you know.
It's cold enough. Don't suppose there's much call for silver spoons round here.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. There's plenty with delusions of grandeur and the wads to pay for it.
Your drink's looking a bit tired.
God helps them that helps themselves. That's my philosophy.
I'll remember that.
Well, Lily. Bravo, Daddy. Dismantling the class barriers. Marvellous gesture.
My dad's gone to bed. Is it all right if our Nathan stops in there with his Lego?
Yes, of course it is.
The Phoenix. Now, what sort of a nomenclature would that be? Your mother must have been a mystical sort of woman.
Oh, no, sirree. My mother christened me Ivy. But I do not relate to leaves. I relate to feathers. The phoenix is, in actuality, my totem symbol.
Thank you, Phoenix. If we can endeavour to set the tone for others to follow.
So, Julie, you are joining us? No, I've laid a place for you. Tonight's a family occasion.
I know you like to give our guests precedence. You're over there. And you're over there.
When do you go back to school?
Well, I actually left about 8 years ago.
Oh, my goodness. You've grown up fast.
Can you get underway, please? Well, in the midst of this unexpected gathering, I'd like to begin by taking a few moments to think about various people who can't be with us this evening. Many and various. But most particularly, Mummy, who I know would be thinking of you all very lovingly and who is greatly missed by us all.
To Mummy. Here.
Memo to any newcomers. Glasses we're drinking from. A gift from Mummy's godfather, worth about £70 apiece. Suggest we proceed with caution when handling them. To Mummy.
To Mummy.
And perhaps you'd care to say grace, Father.
By all means. I am the rose of Sharon and the lily of the valley. As the lily among thorns, so is my love among the daughters. As the apple tree among the trees of the wood, so is my beloved among the sons. I sat down under his shadow with great delight, and his fruit was sweet to my taste. Amen.
Amen.
Sure, your average priest has a vivid imagination.
I beg your pardon?
How else could a man fulminate against the sins of the flesh without having wrapped his own tonsils round the odd, forbidden coxie?
Like a funeral, aren't you?
How do you mean?
Keeping the red down for a while.
So, what do you think of the country life then?
It's all right, I suppose. Not exactly alive and kicking, is it?
Well, don't kid yourself. You think we're all Mr. and Mrs. Woodentop? There's not much you can't get up to around here, if you know what I'm talking about.
Well, where would you look?
Depends what you're after.
I could use a bit of loose change.
I should check out your own doorstep. Not just our teaspoons.
We'll not get far on that, will we? Love us a couple of wedges of bread, just to mop up the juice out some.
I told you this was a mistake. You'll be giving them notice before the night's out.
Oh, I don't think so. The tenancy agreement is quite accommodating. It would take something really outrageous before they were sent packing.
You really ought to go.
Yeah, so what's the problem? Not stopping for your New Year's kiss?
Nah, I'm knackered. I'm off the bed.
On your own?
I need my kip.
Well, if you fancy a water bottle, you know where I am.
I'll bear that in mind.
Which one was four now? Oh, yes. It's a terrible battle. Well, I'm afraid so.
Rather lacking in patience and
I'm
tact.
I'm less for a start.
Never. Any news about new posting? Not as yet. Foreign Office being rather vague.
So splendid for the boys to be able to spend time with their father.
Absolutely, Daddy. I think I speak for us all when I say it's transformed our lives, you being here.
And who's responsible for the little chappie we saw earlier?
Ah, 'tis a love child, conceived within the perspiration of lustful sheets. Thighs are throbbing, loins entwined.
Not one of ours, I can assure you.
So when are we going to hear the patter of tiny feet along these halls again?
Oh, well, I think that's down to Joanna, isn't it?
Not exclusively, Maud. I think you'll find it requires a joint effort.
Wouldn't that be fun? Not quite clear yet how these folk fit into the picture.
They don't. My motto, leave each to his own. Not yet a classless society, no point pretending otherwise. Outsiders welcome to look. Not yet ready to take them to our collective bosom, so to speak.
Still teaching at the old school?
Mm.
Must be such a relief not to have to brave one of those dreadful secondary moderns.
It wouldn't last 5 minutes at a comprehensive.
Well, speaking as someone who's actually part of the system, I can assure you there's very little to choose between private and public education these days.
And how would you know?
I think we're all aware it's a free country.
I couldn't agree more. Pity they ever did away with national service. A great leveller.
Yes, and some people want to learn, some don't. The opportunities are there. It's a question of what we make of them.
Tell that to Open Comprehensive.
Sorry?
Half its windows, third of its teachers, three quarters of its books. AWOL. Ventilation 5, opportunity 0.
Yeah, well, I think you'll find that those who really want to learn will always find the means. I'm sorry, I do know what I'm talking about. In my class, there's one boy, Kevin McElroy. Parents live on a council estate. Scrimped saving with the beer, the cigarettes, the caravan. Just to give their son the benefit of a decent education. So I have had experience of dealing with the underprivileged child. Thank you very much.
Is your man all there, or what?
I don't think coming bottom in maths and getting lines for insolence gives you any room to feel smug, golly-wally.
Bottom in maths?
And top in art.
Not good enough, Morty. Key to his future, mathematics. Something he can use. Something practical. Nothing against art in its proper place.
And where is its proper place?
The value of art, Joanna, lies in its practical application. If it isn't practical, ceases to be art, becomes self-indulgence. Take note, Alistair.
So, you say you have no problem with your waterworks? Well, that's very peculiar. Because this little fella is showing a definite inclination towards diagnosing an overinflated bladder.
John. Eyes peeled.
Sorry, Pa.
Looking for any transgression or offence which would render this tenancy agreement null and void.
Not sure it was such a good thing to invite the tenants round.
And why not?
I obviously not used to doing things out. Thank God.
The cure's in the drawing room shop, as you can. Might as well put idle hands to use, Alistair. Preferably not one of your own compositions. Nothing too intrusive.
Ah, that was an excellent meal, old chap.
Thank you.
Who's your cook?
And possibly...
lighter in here. Would you mind? Feeling better, I see. The change of scenery must have done the trick. It's not something I'd recommend you take advantage of on a regular basis, however.
No, right. I won't.
I'm glad we're agreed on that. Now, shall we join the party?
If we could press ahead with the scheduled festivities, just briefly like to run through the timetable for the rest of tonight's programme. 11:55, foregather to implement the party hats. If we must, moving swiftly on to a small serving of champagne. Midnight, acknowledge the new year. And then I suggest we all get off to bed as quickly as possible. Busy day ahead tomorrow. I think, as a general note, I'd recommend we take time to reassess who we are. What is our purpose? Remind ourselves of our own particular stations. Reinstate some boundaries, as it were. Time check, please, Phoenix.
11:57 and 10 seconds precisely.
Morty, we're running late. I suggest you issue the appropriate headwear. Huh?
Your brother's made a marvellous recovery.
Roger, I don't think you've been introduced.
This is Declan.
All right, mate.
Phoenix, standing by to administer the toast.
Sir.
So, here we all are. I wonder what the new year has in store for us.
I dread to think.
It
Jesus, tonight and tomorrow. What a way to kick off a new season.
Come on. I can hear it's some ancient Celtic ritual.
First footing, old son. Old blood lets out the year that's gone. Young blood lets in the new.
Old blood? Well, that's you, Danny.
Not entirely clear what the point of this is.
For fun, Morty. I can spell it if you like.